Hi, I'm Cassandra Anderson, and I'm so excited today because I have two lovely women, Janice and Monique, and we will be discussing about an association that has been helping quite a bit of people, and these are individuals that are part of the minority group. Right now, I will be talking with Janice. If you would be able to tell us more about yourself, who you are.
Sure. I'm happy to do that. And thank you for making this opportunity for us to have this podcast and enjoy this discussion together. I'm pretty passionate about what I do, so it's an honor to be asked. So a little bit about me. I grew up in Newmarket, and in my current role, I'm the culture programmer for the town of Newmarket in my full-time job. And when I took on the role of launching the cultural center for the town of Newmarket, I felt strongly that I wanted my key decision makers to walk with me in recognizing, nurturing, and supporting the diverse communities we have in Newmarket, and to start really working at building a better foundation in equity, inclusion, and engagement, especially. I have a long-standing awareness and greater understanding of some of the experience of some of the racialized communities. I've had a lot of contact and done a lot of good listening. But I think in my own personal self, I'm not used to doing a lot of what we're doing right now, which is doing a lot of talking. I try to do a lot more listening. You know, we were given two ears and one mouth, so that's a lot about me. But in my other role, the one I'm so passionate about, I'm the vice chair of the Newmarket African Caribbean Canadian Association. And it's a real honor to be a part of the organization. It's a really dynamic, incredible team that's doing a lot in the community and for the community. But I tend to be in a more background role, and I do that with intention because it's a Black-led organization, and although I've been asked to step up to be on the board and am considered an ally, that's a very that's an interesting word because for me it's been a real learning journey, and that's a day in, day out. For me, it means, you know, really good listening, like I've emphasized. It means reading and researching and actively being in the community to, you know, to hear folks and being a voice at the table when that voice themselves can't be there, being an advocate. And just it's been really wonderful for me to, you know, to be able to step up and be a member of the board with NACA. That's a little bit about me.
Thank you for sharing. And you are right. Listening, as another white woman, I understand listening is so important. And I know a lot of individuals in the Black community want us to listen. They just want us to hear them. And so that we can better understand them, understand their culture, understand the struggles, and not so much always talk for them, but really do hear. And I definitely hear that when you say that. So thank you for sharing. And my other question is, tell us more about what happened when creating NACA, like why you created NACA, what it's really about.
Well, from what I understand, because this was prior to my having been involved, I know the history. NACA's foundation was set really solidly as a Black-led organization. A number of folks came together to sit around a table and have a discussion about a desire they had to see true change for the Black community locally. And they were especially wanting to focus on seeing Black youth be supported and nurtured in their growth and their voice and their participation in the community and beyond. NACA's grown to to address so much more. But I think the original intent was really to give voice and for Black people to have active engagement in the community and have equal opportunity in the community. Early on in my days with the organization, and continuing that, what I shared with you about that good listening, we've had to really pivot as an organization to meet some really foundational needs. And so we've grown to meet the needs of food security, mental wellness, and these programs have evolved and emerged as a result. But it's a very diverse organization. And, I've been pleased to be a part of it, but I wasn't part of that founding team, but I continue to be very actively engaged nevertheless. And I think, always walking in that conscious willingness to know and understand that I don't have direct lived experience and I'm in support of the organization as an ally, but some of those same people are still involved and are seeing some of their dreams coming to fruition because NACA has been very, very, very active, as you may well know.
Thank you. And with that being said, what challenges would you say that you faced?
Well, I think being a Black-led organization, we see where there are gaps, where there are needs, and we face many of the same challenges that exist universally for Black and African communities. And they include the simplest things that most organizations encounter. Well, they're not simple. I shouldn't use that word, really. They're very complicated, but basically deeply entrenched anti-Black racism and systems of colonialism. And just to give you some examples, working with community organizations and the schools and the government, where there's just a long-standing lack of awareness around those issues that Black people face every day, and the deeply entrenched systemic racism that's really alive and well, and for the most part ignored. I think as Canadians, a lot of folks, they don't really have a deeper understanding until there's an act of violence. And it's unfortunate that it takes that to bring it to the surface and for people to become more aware. So I think as an organization, just trying to get started and really being recognized as a strong leader. We've seen the direct impacts of COVID-19 and the impacts upon the community around job loss and food insecurity and community isolation. And that's especially for youth and seniors, but NACA, had a strong need to pivot and address mental wellness needs along with the need for food for the community, just as an example. And, where do we make that happen? How do we make that happen? We heard from the community that that was important to address. So that challenge that we faced was pivoting to meet that need. And being a small organization and being volunteer led, that's a challenge and a half to take on, but we did. And we were able to apply for some funding, and we've also started a mental wellness program for adults and a new one for youth. But just trying to manage the needs, the complex needs of the community with a volunteer organization is a challenge. And so we'll be looking to the future to see that we get more staff hired for the organization. But it's challenging because funding is limited, and it's in pockets, you know? So seeking that and trying to augment that need on a, you know, in a foundational way is important. One of the things we did recently was we did obtain our charitable status, which is really helpful to us as an organization moving forward. But even that process was onerous. It was, you know, it's hard to get that status. I think some of the other challenges that we've faced are, we see so much anti-Black racism going on in the schools, especially impacting children and youth, and, you know, trying to, you know, to act and support, to be an advocate for those families. We've faced blank stares and folks that really don't understand what that truly means. And so we're asked as an organization to try to support them, but in fact, we're not here to do their work. You know, we're here to help and support, but we can't do their work. They have to start and begin to, you know, to take stock of what's going on in their particular environment, whether it be a school or, well, I'll speak to some more of the experience that we've had in some of the organizations that we've dealt with as we talk further. But I think a big thing is, as well, Cassandra, is not seeing Black faces everywhere you have to go. Just to be at a meeting and having the experience of, you know, being the only Black face around the table where there's there are a lot of decision making things being discussed. So it's just for us trying to be a lot of places and trying to find ways of you know, using our time wisely and really supporting organizations but not doing their work. That's been a challenge as well.
So with some of those challenges, it sounds like a little bit of overcoming them, from what I'm understanding, is trying to pivot. I've been hearing a lot. Is there anything else that you would add in that has helped overcome some of these challenges that you have explained that you guys have been facing?
Well, I think the most important thing is really what you think you know is really getting, like, right directly from the community confirmation of that. So actively listening to the community is really the key foundation to all of it. So in the pivoting, you know, we heard via a survey that was delivered throughout the region that there were specific needs. And so being able to listen to the community is really important. We've been working with the government at all levels to help educate and basically direct them to support us, you know, to better understand the real barriers to the community that we serve, but also to provide more support in ways that they're able to. So just as an example, we've worked closely with the town of Newmarket and as a result, we've developed an anti-racism, anti-Black racism plan and plan of action. And that's being implemented, but as well, you know, just they've provided space and support for us to celebrate the annual Black History Month and showcase any of the events and activities that, you know, that the community wants to during the course of the year.
Wow. Yeah, that's a lot of nice, rich information that you are sharing with us. And I definitely agree that Black History Month should be more than just the month. This is also where I would like to introduce Monique. Actually, I would love it if Monique, if you could introduce yourself, who you are, and how you're connected to NACA, and what your thoughts about.
Okay, well, whoever is listening to this, hi, my name is Monique Thompson. I'm currently a student in the Human Rights and Diversity Program at Wilfrid Laurier University. I'm very interested in studying immigration, diversity, and I'm very happy that Cassandra invited me here today to explain what NACA is.
And I'm very excited that you're here with us today. And that kind of goes leading into our first question, and that is, can you explain in your own words what the organization NACA is to the audience that is listening?
Okay, so basically NACA stands for New Market African Caribbean Canadian Association. And it was first started by someone who I'm very close to, which is actually my cousin. So this this association was created to invite basically all different minorities to come together and just basically celebrate what it is to be different, what it is to have culture, what it is to show people like what it means to be like, you know, a colored person in society. And I felt like this association ties very closely to like Black roots, Black culture, and it gives us like, you know, different insights on, you know, how Black people are, African descent, which is very important to learn about too.
Thank you. So just like how you said, how you got introduced to NACA is also from your cousin. Mm-hmm. And so with that being said, how did you get yourself involved with NACA, and why did you start working with NACA?
I basically like the different values that NACA was promoting, and that really caught my eye as, you know, a Black female. I was really interested in learning more about like my African descent and like, sorry, my cousin was making me laugh. Okay. And I'm learning more about like who I am as a Black female. It's amazing to see like other people like myself, you know, all come together, and we all share different stories about like, you know, who we are. And it makes me feel included that I have a group in society that I can go to if I have problems or if I have worries about like how I identify, you know. And I was just interested in joining NACA because, you know, it was the first ever Black association like created in Newmarket. So obviously I'm joining, like there's no questions or buts, you know.
And what were the first events and activities did you get connected with then? Especially that it's the first Black organization in Newmarket. So going back, what can you tell us that you remember doing?
Wow, this question like brings me back to like probably 5 years ago. I've been in NACA. Like I was basically asked to sing the national anthem. Okay. So that was a pretty big experience. And I was also on the dance team with my church. So we also did a performance for NACA. And it was really exciting to know that this was right in my hometown. Like I can participate and, you know, show my talents in a community that, you know, accepts me. You know what I mean? Like encourages me to be the best person I can be, basically.
That's nice, because that goes into my next question is, do you feel that NACA has really made a difference in Newmarket, Ontario specifically? And if so, how and why do you think that?
I think NACA honestly was something that Newmarket needed. And the reasons why I say that is because it literally made like, basically Newmarket, as we know, is a very like, you know, not too diverse town. Right. So having NACA promotes diversity and promotes, you know, people of color to all come together. You know, since joining NACA, I've met so much other people that I never knew even lived in Newmarket. So, you know, that was like cool to meet different people like that. And I feel like NACA also brings a lot of value, not just we're going to be talking about like African descent and like how Black people are, but we're going to help them, you know, have mental health programs, have financial group programs. I actually won a scholarship from them to go into university. So like they helped the community a lot. So I think NACA, you know, in general, they just helped the community, to sum it up.
Yeah. I even found that because it helped Kayana to get into Techie Kids as well. And I thought that was really nice. And so even with the last question I have here, what do you think NACA could add more into their organization that could be helpful? Or do you see them able to expand further than just Newmarket? And if so, what are your thoughts?
So basically, I love how NACA is. Obviously, since it's such a new organization, it's not going to be like at its highest potential, but it's at its best potential, in my opinion. You know, that's something like NACA is a great organization. I feel like in the future, like, I don't know, like maybe like creating new programs that are like restricted to like Black people and I guess, I don't know, promoting more, like I guess highlighting more like Black people in Newmarket who are doing like great things, like great achievements, you know what I mean? They already do that for the scholarship, but I feel like just in general would be nice. But I honestly feel like, you know, Jerisha's doing a great job and like, it's not easy to run an organization. Like it is, I wouldn't do it because I feel like that's too much responsibility, but kudos to her for, you know, creating NACA and making it so beautiful, you know, and even like throwing it back to her. Like, I remember she also created this organization. Sorry, I'm like stuttering, cut that out. But I was going to say something about, she also has something called the Iris Malcolm Library. And I found that very sweet because I actually knew Iris, which is her mom. And she was part of my family as well. She knew my grandma. So she was a very inspirational woman. So one thing I love how NACA did is that they like, they're telling people about who she is as a woman. And I feel like some people's stories aren't too shared. So the fact that her story is being shared and it's a part of NACA, it's great that that's a great addition.
Well, thank you very much, Monique, of explaining all of this wonderful information as well, including Janice. Both of you, thank you so much for giving not only myself, but the audience more information regarding NACA. That wonderful information and telling us exactly what NACA stands for, what it's about, what people can get from this association, and the wonderful work that you actually do as well amongst the organization. Again, anybody that would like to volunteer at NACA, you can find them at their website at www.nacacommunity.ca. You can type in Google NACA Newmarket, and there is a list there about contact donate, mainstream fund, food security, job opportunities, and more. Thank you. helped NACA as well.